the Huawei Y9 2019, the Xiaomi Mi A2, the Honor 8X, the Xiaomi Redmi Note 6 Pro. Why am I taking all these names? Because these are the smartphones that are available in almost the same price bracket like that of the Mi 8 Lite and offer identical specs. So can the Mi 8 Lite stand out among the plethora of mid-range devices available in the market? Let's find out. First of all, let's clear out the name game here. Xiaomi has released three phones in the Mi 8 lineup, the Mi 8, which is a flagship model, the Mi 8 SE and the Mi 8 Lite, which are cheaper variants, and the Mi 8 Lite is the most affordable among all. From the design standpoint, we see improvements in the latest version. We see curvy edges, an attractive glass back and a shiny aluminium border with 2.5D curved glass. Topping it all is the colors, and this particular variant is amazingly eye-catching. There is a fingerprint reader at the back, just like how we find it in other Xiaomi phones, and does its job quite well. The scanning is fast and does it correctly all the time. We do not find a face unlock feature though, which is strange for a phone of 2019. The phone is premium on hold but is slightly wider than the others out there. That does not make a difference in usage though, just putting it out there. The camera bump creates some imbalance when the phone is kept on a plain surface, carrying chances of getting the camera scratched over time, which Xiaomi has well addressed by providing a silicone case with the phone. Talking about the back, as attractive as it is to the normal eye, it is a fingerprint magnet, so no denying that. I like how the phone feels on hands, but it's sad that I had to use a cover to protect it most of the times. So on the design front, the phone is what we would expect from a current smartphone, and it's also noteworthy that no cutouts has been made on this area. The display is one of the best parts about the Mi 8 Lite, and I mean that very seriously. It's a 6.26-inch IPS LCD panel with a tall 19:9 aspect ratio and 1080p resolution. This might sound as if we are getting a usual thing, but the display here is pretty dope. I mean, the colors, the brightness, and the calibration all fit in perfectly to give you a pleasing display. It's a sharp one with very good viewing angles. The sunlight legibility is decent and nothing extraordinary. In terms of the display size, it might be a little less than the 6.5 inches seen on the Y9 2019 and the Honor 8X, but I see no major setback here. On the top, you get a notch that is not, well, an ugly one. It's smaller than the Mi 8 SE and similar to the Honor 8X and Y9 2019. You do have an option to hide it, but the black bar on the top is clearly visible at certain angles. Okay, let's move on to the cameras now. The cameras at the back on this one is similar to that of the Mi 8 SE. There's a 12+5-megapixel dual cameras at the back and it works just fine. The colors are good and the pictures from the normal cameras look decent, nothing extraordinary. The dynamic range is average and with the HDR on, you get some improvements. The AI feature that's there gives you some punchiness in images and nothing more. The portrait mode will give you a somewhat disappointed feeling though. At times, the amount of blur is very uneven and it looks unnatural too. Similarly, the dual cameras suffer poor edge detection. Night shots, I must say, are pretty average too. In extreme low light conditions, there are grains all over, and as the light gets better, the pictures look better too. Focus during the nighttime is slow. However, the shots are good in artificial lighting though. The selfies that I got from this one are actually great. Although there is some processing being done and you cannot shut it off, but the output is not bad at all. It's a 24-megapixel camera that gives you good results. The portrait mode, though with a single camera, is surprisingly good, better than the back camera actually. Nighttime selfies are a bit noisy though. In the video part, you get options for recording in 1080p at 60 or 30fps, 4K at 30fps, and 720p at 30fps. The device has EIS and the videos are more stabilized except while recording in 4K. I found the 1080p at 30fps to have better quality and stabilization. Now, the performance. Snapdragon 660 seems like a sweet spot for Xiaomi. It's there on the Mi A2 and the recently announced Xiaomi Redmi Note 7. And it's not a bad chipset by any means, but it seems like Xiaomi has started standardizing the chipset used on its mid-range devices. And the performance is what we would expect. Switching between apps is fluid and multitasking is fine too. But when put in comparison with the Kirin 710 of the Huawei Y9, apps open a little slow on the Mi 8 Lite. However, when talking about the GPU performance, games load faster in the Mi 8 Lite than the Huawei Y9 2019. Not a major difference here. Gameplay is smooth with Adreno 512 counterpart. I played PUBG and Asphalt 9, and only in PUBG I felt some stutters. Everything else went fine. Talking about the software, you get Android Oreo 8.1 with MIUI 10.0.5 on top. I am not a huge fan of the MIUI since the Redmi Note 6 Pro had some issues with advertisements playing even in File Explorer. I had expected the same with this one, but thank God nothing of that sort has happened. Moving on, the notifications can be cleared from one direction only, which has confused me many times. But I like the animations going around inside the settings menu, it's quite fun I must say. And I might be saying this very late, but I also very much like the brightness panel and the volume rocker panel. And if you are a fan of gesture navigation, don't worry, you get that too in here. This particular model has 4GB RAM and 64GB internal storage that can be further expanded to 256GB using the SIM2 slot. There is also a 6GB RAM and 128GB ROM variant available, and I must say at this price, the storage being offered is pretty decent. Okay, now let's get on to the battery side of things. This one here features a 3350mAh battery, and we very well know that the Snapdragon 660 is not that power efficient when put in comparison to the Kirin 710. Plus, with the 4000mAh battery on the Huawei Y9 2019, the Mi 8 Lite is nowhere comparable. And talking about the endurance, you get very average battery life that makes you put this on charge at the end of the day. Similarly, gaming drains the battery in a considerably faster pace. Nonetheless, it gets you through the day. The device also supports Quick Charge 3.0, but you only get a 10-watt charger inside the box. I used the Quick Charger and the charging time improved considerably. Also, you cannot ignore the fact that you get a USB Type-C port here. I must say that Xiaomi is very generous in providing the latest on the hardware side. Onto the extras, the speakers get moderately loud on audio and video playback, but when headphones are plugged in, the output is not very loud from the USB Type-C port. Yes, you got it, there is no headphone jack, and while some of you might accept it, it might turn off many people, including me. The buttons are placed at a reachable distance and are clicky and haptic too. As I said in the beginning, the Mi 8 Lite has been launched at a time when there is a cluster of devices in the mid-range segment. Yes, it is a good device with good performance and good everything, and you will not regret buying it for the price being as, but you will not regret buying the Honor 8X or the Huawei Y9 2019 either. So the Mi 8 Lite is just another addition to the choices. And in any ways, if the Redmi Note 7 makes its way here early in Nepal, it will not be hard choosing the Redmi Note 7 over the Mi 8 Lite. So that was all for the review. Just wanted to say that I have been eagerly waiting for the Redmi Note 7 to launch here in Nepal. And if you feel the same, please do comment down below. Till then, I am Pratima Adhikari, and thank you for watching.